So, the first time I saw Anna, the first thing I noticed would have to have been her smile. We were at a very expensive bar slash restaurant at the time, and I was ordering a beer. And when she walked in, I saw that she was laughing and having a great time right out of the gate. So I knew that she was very nice and probably wouldn't be mean to me. So that was my first thought. Who wears the pants in this relationship? What does this awesome war picture hanging at the landing or stairwell tell you? I do. I definitely wear the pants. However, the more I think about it, the more I believe that Anna probably does. She just allows me to think that I do. And it's good enough. Oh, hi. Pet names. First off, I'm well aware that there are plenty of family members present, so I'm going to have to take a very politically correct approach to this question. I know Bear would be one of them, but if it's just one, the answer's probably going to be Peach's McGillicuddy, which is just outrageous and crazy, but if I had to bet, that's the one I'd pick. What is my most annoying habit? Probably that I care too much. Drives Anna crazy. As far as her annoying habits go, I'd have to say she really doesn't have any. But if I had to pick a few, it would probably be that she leaves the burner on, the oven on, maybe the barbecue on. Loves to leave her straightener on. So she does do these things that kind of lead to one thing, and that as a fireman, I take very seriously, but she loves to do it. It's kind of our thing. So if there was a bad habit, that would have to be it. Who's a better driver? Me. See how long that took? Actually, you hear that? You hear the sirens? She's probably almost home. So, if that's not enough for you, I got some actual tangible evidence to prove that, yeah, she's not all that safe. What is that right there? Notice of traffic violation. And there she goes, stopped behind the line, decided to go anyway, because why? She got to get her nails done, okay? You know, I'll give her this. She's probably better at parallel parking, okay? So maybe award a quarter credit, but yeah, not even close. I went to the store to get a treat for Anna. What would I get? It's kind of a trick question because if there's a treat that she always wants, it would have to be frozen yogurt. However, I would need her to go with me in order to make sure I got the correct toppings. So that's my answer. I don't know if that's what you're looking for, but that's what you're gonna get. I'll give you something to cry about. Oh, hey. How you doing? Who's better with kids? Probably have to be Anna. I'm pretty good with injured and sick kids, but you know, day-to-day stuff, she's the best. She definitely wins. Our first kiss, actually, we were on your couch, Julie, when it went down, and we were fittingly watching the movie called The End of the World, because that's a little Frankie foreshadowing for you. But yeah, that was where it went down. Of course she initiated. I'm a gentleman. I would wait until she was comfortable, and that's all we did, and then I went home. If Anna could only bring one item on the honeymoon, well, it's pretty easy to me. I don't know if it's what we're going for, but I know if there's only one thing she could bring, it would be this little face right here. There's no doubt that that is all she would bring. In fact, she'd probably rather bring that than me. So to answer your question, little ZZ. Our song? Well, you know, I gotta be honest, I haven't finished writing it yet. I'm still kind of tuning it, making sure it's just how I want it to be. But to answer the question, because you need a complete song and not one that's still in the making, I'd have to go with Brad Paisley's Today, because it's a perfect friggin' song. I mean, what can I say? The guy's got talent for days. That's our song.
When I'm sitting in traffic some afternoon, or bored to death in some waiting room, well, I'm gonna close my eyes and picture you today. You keep brushing that hair back out of your eyes, and it just keeps falling, and so do I. Well, I'm feeling like the luckiest man alive. Of your life, I know it won't always be like this. Life can change.